Okay, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Okay, folks, welcome back to another lesson. We're looking at solving simple equations. Now, we carry on from our last video, so it's called more 2 plus step equations. Okay, so Adil is with me here again today. He's joined us for this one-to-one and with all of you as well. Right, the sheet that we're doing, let's just see if we can get this onto the camera. We are moving on to part 6, then followed on by part 7, 8, and 9. And then a revision question on the bottom 10. Hope you can see those. Right, if you can't see those, they'll be in another video, hopefully. And that's okay, right, let's have a look. Okay, let's try some different questions that we've done the other day. So number one. We have, here we go, okay. Okay, let's double check in that all this is coming onto the video. Okay, it is. I'll try some different lighting. That's okay as well. Right. Right, here's our first question for today. 10x plus 7 equals 57. Can you see me in the here? See me in there? Probably. Okay. Right. Okay. Mr. Ready? What was here? Okay, now. We always start the question at x. Always start at x. When we start the equation, we start reading the equation from x. Okay, we need to see whether we understand what's actually going on. Now, we need to look at what's being done to the x. So the first thing that's been done to the x, which is right here, even though the plus sign's been over there, the first thing that's been done to the x is the time by 10. So we're going to label that first action. Okay, for those of you who've seen the previous videos, thinking, hang on a second, this method looks too long, it's too complicated. This method is very simple. This is just the technique. Once you know the technique, you'll be doing it without even thinking about it. So, if you don't follow a technique and start with the question, you'll be confused each time you do a new question. Start at the x, what's being done first is the time by 10. What's second? So the rules, as we've done in the previous video, is start from x, read the equation, and then identify, work out what happened first, what happened second. Okay? You're like an investigator. You say, oh, hang on a second, from this equation, I know this happened first event, that's the second event. Now to solve the situation or to solve this problem, we have to start from the last action first. So, okay. Right, where do you start first? You start the first action, second action?
Second action first, yeah.
So we start the second action first. Second action, we always start at the end. Second action, opposite of plus 7 will become?
Take 7.
So copy everything down. So 57, take away 7, it gives you?
50.
This part gets copied down, and I like the word, remember I said to you before, you heard the word copy a lot. I want you to copy the equal down in the same place, get this answer in the same, in that place. The 10x gets copied down, copy things down, keep the maths consistent and beautiful. So when the examiner looks at your work, he's thinking, wow, this person really understands mathematics. Now, we have to undo the first action. So you move the last action first, then you're gonna move the first action. So, we have here a invisible time. So for these we have to multiply by 10 is?
Divide by 10.
Excellent. So let's copy down the x, copy down the x, copy down the equal. 50 divided by 10 will give us an answer of 5. So as I said before, a two-step question is not a harder question, it is a longer question. It's the difference between saying we have one toast for breakfast and the next morning you have two toasts. two toast isn't harder to eat, it just takes longer. So this question has got two parts, where the one step question has one part. So you've got two one step questions built into this one question. We have to identify what was done first, second, and then move them in the right order. That's the end of the first question for today. Okay, let's rub this question down and make room for the second question. Okay. Okay. Right, have you got me on there? Yeah, I'm all on there. Okay, lovely. Okay, so I'm going to choose all the kind of the odd looking questions on these. Right, where have I put all my markers? What do I have on here? Oh, that's actually making it worse. Right, keep to this one. Oh, we're having some issues here. I'll put the markers. Here. There's the markers. No, but... there. That I was just using. Okay. Another question. Question number two. Let's have a look at this one here. (20 = 2x + 9). Okay, now you're probably thinking, Adil, what's happening here? So why is the x now on the right hand side? It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Before the left hand side. Does that make a problem for us?
No.
No, it shouldn't make a problem for us. If we have the x on the right, we're going to move it to the?
Left.
Everything to the left. Before we were on the right, we moved everything to the?
Right.
Sorry, we're on the left, we went to the right. Now, we're on the right hand side. Let's start again at the x. Start. Read. Okay. What's the word for read now, Abby? Ikra. Yeah, let's read this equation. So we have x is first of all being doubled. We call that the first action. Then it is being added by 9, second action. This first part is the very important. Otherwise, you'll end up saying, oh, well, let's just move this one first. And if you don't know which one's first and second, then you don't know which one's the last one. So this is the second equation, plus 9. Second part of the equation. Now, what do we do with the plus 9?
Minus
2. We take it from the right to the?
Left.
Minus 9. So we have 20 minus 9. 20 minus 9 will give us an answer of?
11.
Okay, this is the part where a lot of students, they flip out. They say, oh no, hang on a second. I can't do 11 divided by 2. I've made a mistake. Let's stop, put the brakes on, and let's run around the room. No, nothing to worry about here. You just gotta know how to deal with numbers that don't divide exactly. So, let's carry on with our theme. We move the second action first. Now we're gonna move the first action last. So, opposite time by 2 is?
Divide by 2.
Divide by 2. Okay. So, x is equal to 11 divided by 2. I don't normally call it this way in the question, but we'll, for this moment we will. What's 11 divided by 2?
11 divided by 2.
So that, how many 2's go into 11? That would be?
5.
5 remainder? 1. Now 5 remainder 1, is that an acceptable mathematical answer? Can you give that to your teacher, sir? Some answers 5 remainder 1. It's okay as a rough answer here. That's not the final answer, is it? So if we look at 11 over 2, so we have 11 divided by 2 is 5 whole. And the remainder goes to the top, and the bottom number gets copied to the bottom. So 11 halves makes 5 whole ones and 1 half. Okay, because 10 halves make 5. You've got an extra half, so that's 5 and a half. So that's what the answer is. Okay. Right. So x is equal to 5 and a half. What we say is there, 5 and a half is equal to x. It doesn't matter which way around we write it. But that's another question. Now, this question involves here dividing by a number which end of the remainder. So don't get worried, oh, I've done a mistake, why have I got a remainder? In mathematics, we do get remainders. You get remainders, you get fractional answers, you get negative fractional answers, you get decimal answers. So be ready for it. Don't think, oh, I've done it wrong automatically. You haven't necessarily done it wrong. So that's done, 5 and a half is right. So put 5 and a half in here. 2 times by 5.5 is? 11. 11 out of 9 is 20. It works. Fantastic. Ready for the next question? Okay. That's it. Okay, right, let's look at another question. Right, we've had a look at the two addition questions. Let's have a look at a subtraction question. Oh, that looks nice. Right, let's have a look at this one here. 68. Okay, 68, where's it on 68? Equals 8x minus 12. Okay, we've got a minus in there. Now this time. Okay, let's have a go at that one. Right. Okay, Theo. Where do you start the question?
From
the x. Then we have to read the question. What's been done to the x? X has been multiplied by 8. It's called the first action. That's the first thing done to the x. Okay, Kia, where's the markers I was just using, Kia? New one. This is another new one. Where's it all on? The brand new ones. Where did I put them?
The red box.
No, I was just using them. This is not a new one. This is not one of the new ones. What did they do? Under there. Excuse me, folks, give me 1 second. I've lost. Alright. There they are. Excuse me, folks, just give me 1 second while I get my markers organized. Okay, right. There's the new one. New red marker right away. Time by 8 is the first action, that makes the minus 12 the
second action.
So what have we done? It starts with the x. We've identified the first, second action. So we've done 2 steps already. Now we have to solve it. Which action do I move first? Do I move the first or the second first?
Second first.
Well done. You will start from the end of the actions. You solve them in reverse order. So the reverse order starts at the end, second action or third action. Okay, let's move the minus 12 over. The minus 12 comes over here and becomes a?
Add 12.
Lovely. Copy the equal down. Copy the 8x down because that hasn't moved. The minus 12 has moved, it's gone over there. Should it be here as well?
No.
If you move something from right, it should be on the left. So now we have here 68 add 12. 68 add the 2 will give you 70. Add another 10 will give you?
80.
Looks like a nice 10 is a nice fat number. Juicy numbers 80s are. Okay, right, let's have a look how we do the next what. Opposite time by 8 is?
Divide by
8. Okay. So we copy the x down. X hasn't moved. The time by 8 has moved. Opposite time by 8 is divide by 8. 80 divided by 8 will give you an answer of?
10.
So the questions after a while become?
Easy.
Once you understand the technique, look at the question, identify the actions, reverse the actions, you just go through the process, alhamdulillah, we can get the right answer. Okay, are we ready to move on to a 3-step question? Yeah? Ready for it? Okay, Adil's ready for a 3-step question, inshallah. Let's just hope that he is right here. He's ready for it. Okay. Right, we have a little squirrel that's joined us in the room. Sorry, sir, please leave. Please go. Okay, right. Alright. Okay. Alright. Little squirrel that joined us. Just looking at the view. That looks good. Alhamdulillah. Okay. Deal is ready for the big one. Alright, let's have a look at a 3-step question. Okay, let's have a look at a nice one. Mm. 66 is equal to 6 times by 6x minus 7. For the horse, that was really hard. Remember the example of a toast?
Yeah.
First toast, second toast, and third toast. Is eating three toasts harder than eating two toasts? No, just takes more time. Okay, just think of these as toast. We've got three toasts in this question. Right, let's start the question. Right, what's the first thing we do? We must start at the start of the x. Then we must read the equation, iqra the equation. So, what's been done to the x first of all right here?
Times
by 6. That's called the first action. After it was times by 6, after what was done next? Minus 7, which is called the second action. Now, after we multiplied it by 6 and minus 7, what did we do next after we've done all that? We got the answer there, and then we multiplied it by 6. So this is called the third action. Right. What does the rule say when we solve the equation without giving you 3 actions, 5 actions, or 10 actions? Where do we start when we have to solve it? Do we do the first one first now, or do we do the last one first? The last one first. We go in reverse order. So when we're going to solve this equation, we have 1, 2, 3 things happening. We're going to start at the last item. The last thing to happen was the third action. We're going to start here according to the rule. Rule will start at the end. The end action, the last action, and start unraveling it in reverse order. So, opposite time by 6 is? Divide by 6. So you have 66 divided by 6. So that gives us a nice and beautiful 11. Okay, so 6 divided by 6 is 1, 6 divided by 6 is 1, that is 11. Yeah? Happy? Now, what's missing now? What was there before that's gone now?
Brackets.
Why am I taking the brackets off? Because we don't need them anymore. All of this here, because we had a time by 6 acting on the whole lot, once the time by 6 is gone, we don't need to have the brackets anymore. There's no need for the brackets. And by having the brackets, it actually causes issues, because then you can't move things. Okay, so the brackets have gone because the time by 6 has gone. So now we're left with 6x minus 7. So what we need to do now, go back. We've done the third action first. Now we've got to go to the
second
action. The second action is?
Minus.
That comes over. Opposite of minus 7 is?
Seven.
Add 7. Change side, change sign. So 11 add 7 will give you?
18,
yeah? Okay. Now, we've done the third action, we've done the second action, we're going in reverse. What's last now for us? The first action. So we have to do opposite time by 6, which is equal to?
Divide by 6.
Okay. So 18 divided by 6 is equal to?
3.
Well done, Adil. Excellent. That's a 3-step question. If you show your teacher you can do this in school, your teacher will be well impressed. That you understand how to read the question, first, second, third action, you move it in reverse order, your teacher will be well impressed, the examiner will be well impressed, that you have an understanding of the. Come here, make a video. Okay, there's more squirrels trying to join us in the lesson. Okay, right. So, first, second, third action, we've reversed them, we've done the question. It's a question that most students will look at this question and go, oh my god, I don't want to do this question. It looks too long. It's too complicated. It is not too long. And it is not too complicated. This type of questions, I teach it to students normally when they are in year 4 / year 5 of junior school, even though this work actually comes into secondary school level, because it's that easy to understand as long as you have the right type of technique. So you don't need to be a particular age to do the algebra, you just need to have the right understanding. So for those young students out there, for those parents who want to challenge their younger children, don't be put off thinking the question looks complicated, it's a secondary school question, we can leave it to later. If your child can handle it, handle the technique, go for it. Teach it to a 6-year-old or a 7-year-old or an 8-year-old, teach it to whoever can handle it. Why wait to a particular age? Try with them, if they understand it, go for it. Okay, Adil, are you happy with that?
Yeah.
Should we do one more example of this?
Yeah.
With the, yeah? Okay, let's go for one more example on the 3-step one with the brackets. Okay. example on the three step ones, and then Adil will be ready to rock and roll. Inshallah, to rock it and roll. Okay. Right, let's have a look. Let's have a look. Was that one had minus in it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do the plus in it. Let's do the triple one, the plus on this side. Okay. Okay, right. What do we do? We always start, look at the X. Look at the X, start from here. Okay, we need to see what's been done to the X, identify the actions. So we have time by five, is going to be called the
first action.
That's the first thing to be done to the X. Then after it was time by five, then it was added by three. And that's called the second action. And after it was time by five, added by three, all of that was then, what's happening here?
Times.
Third action. So how many actions do we have?
Three
actions, or we call it three toast. Yeah? We have to reverse them. Now, do I start, which action do I start with first? The third action, the last action. When you're going to solve, we start from the last action first and we go in reverse order. So that moves first, then that one, and then that one. Okay, opposite time by two is?
Divide by two.
So we're moving from the left hand side to the right hand side to change some times to a?
Divide.
Okay, we change side, we change sign. So 36 divided by 2 is equal to?
18.
Okay, now we copy everything else down. Okay. Alright. Okay, now what we have left now, we have to do the third action. Now you have to move to the
second.
So we go in reverse, third, then second, then first. So we now have to move the plus three. And that becomes a?
Take
away three. What do we do now? Copy everything down. Keyword copy. Copy is a word that everyone says in school, don't copy my work. Stop copying me. I want you to copy my work. Okay? So 18 minus 3 is equal to? 15. Okay, happy with that?
Yeah.
Now, what action have we got left now?
Right.
The way you see me do my work here, circling and taking over arrows, opposite, add, minus, I need you to see your work exactly the same style. I don't see lines without arrows. Okay? I don't see minus be a huge one, minus be small on the side. Different colours even better when you're doing your work to set it out properly, yeah? If you have a second colour. Opposite time by five is?
Divide by five.
So we have 15 divided by 5 and the final answer is 3. Okay. Now Adil is ready to do his work. Okay. Earlier slip of the tongue, rock and roll. I don't want you to rock and roll, I want you to be dancing in here. Okay. But what I mean is Adil is now ready to do these questions, the two step questions and the three step questions. Inshallah, he'll be okay. All right. Okay, folks, that's the end of our more 2 plus step questions video. Inshallah, we're gonna stop the video now and Adil's gonna do some of his classwork followed by homework. Okay, thank you for joining us on this video and inshallah, we'll see you in the next video. Assalamu alaikum.